Hello everyone, Keith here, and today I'm playing Slain Back From Hell, developed by Wolf Brew Games and published by Digiretta Publishing. For those of you who don't know, Slain Back From Hell was actually originally Slain, which was released March 24th, I believe, was the release date of the original version. The original version was met with mixed reception, and the developer actually decided that he would address a lot of the issues and complaints that people had with Slain, and he re-released it, updated it. And this is what this is, Slain Back From Hell. It's the updated version of Slain. Very cool of the developer to do that. You don't really see that a lot where the developer actually acknowledges a lot of the mistakes with the game and fixes them and releases like a free update. So that's pretty cool. Anyway, I'm going to go ahead and jump right into the game here. I'm going to go ahead and do continue. I'm kind of at a weird point in the game where I'm like a... Yeah, I'll show you guys. Yeah, there's a weird point in the game where you like get turned into a wolf. But anyway, for those of you who don't know, Slain is like a 2D action platformer, very much in the vein of Castlevania. And it's not unfair to call it a game that's similar to Dark Souls. There are definitely some similarities that can be drawn between this and Dark Souls, particularly in the parry system. I think this game has a very similar parry system to Dark Souls. I'm gonna get done with this sequence real quick so I can actually show you guys how the game regularly is. I'm actually doing terrible at this part. Yeah, anyway, now I'm playing back into my character. This is usually how you play. That was just a weird sequence where the game transforms you into a wolf. Very strange. Oh, whoa. Let's try to... Okay. Oh, crap. I think I gotta... Oh, God, what is going on? Yeah, so this is the regular gameplay of the game. Like I said, it's a 2D action side-scroller. Very much in the vein of Castlevania. And it's very challenging. The game's constantly throwing new environments and new enemy types at you. Oh crap, wow. So you'll be dying often. You'll be dying a lot, actually. Oh crap, let's see if I can... Damn it. And one thing that's also important, one thing that makes this game difficult is that timing is pretty vital. You really gotta take into account, you know, how many frames it takes for you to swing your sword and stuff, so that way you don't get wrecked by an enemy, you know. It's very important to time things perfectly, especially with things like parrying. Parrying in this game is very difficult to do, but it's totally worth learning because it's so satisfying just to land a parry. Okay, I think this is the best strategy. Okay, and I think it's the last one. Okay. Oh, actually, this is, I've met a, I think this is a boss, or no, it wasn't, I just powered up my magic for nothing. So yeah, you have a jump, obviously, and you have a, oh, this screen very much reminds me of, Castlevania as well. Oh yeah, we have some, yeah, anyway, yeah, so you have a jump, you have a attack, which is X. I'm playing this game on a gamepad. I definitely recommend playing this game with a controller. I think, while it is possible to play the game with a controller, I think that it's not the best way to play this game. Or really, I just think any type of platforming game is best played with a controller, in my opinion. But yeah, anyway, so yeah, you can switch between different weapons. I think there's about three or four weapon types. There's the basic sword, the ice axe, and I think there's also a fire weapon. I'm not sure. I haven't actually gotten that far in the game yet, but I've seen it. It's best to switch. There are certain enemies that are weak to certain weapons, so, you know, it doesn't matter which weapon you select. You know, certain weapons are more effective against others, so, you know, you do have to keep that in mind whenever you're battling enemies. Yeah, I'm actually going to show you guys, next time I run into an enemy, hopefully I can show you guys the parrying. So you can block with Y. And if you block at the exact moment like an enemy weapon hits you, you get a parry. You can also hold X the attack button, and when you let go at the precise moment, you do a power attack. So that's what I mean about this game requiring really precise timing. You can't just like hold X and then just constantly hold the power button. You actually have to time it perfectly, or you know, it'll just fizzle out and won't do anything. Oh god, I'm trying to demonstrate the parrying. Oh god. Yeah, I'm gonna try to practice the parrying here so I can show you guys how the parrying system works. It's very fun and very satisfying whenever you land a parry. There you go, right there. See right there, I blocked at the exact moment, and that gave me made him open for a counterattack. Yeah, and the counterattacks are very brutal. Like, they do a lot of damage. And, oh yeah. See, if you just regularly block an attack, it'll just get destroyed like I just did right there. You also have mana. If you look at my health at the top left, below that is a blue bar. That's obviously your mana meter, your mana. And if you do RB, you can shoot a little like magic missile. And if you hold RB, you can shoot a powered up version. Oh yeah, that's the thing that I jump up with. Yeah, I forgot about that thing. And you can also do a backdash with LB. Doesn't consume any resources or anything. The backdash is actually pretty good, but I tend to forget to use it sometimes because I'm terrible at this game. And the game is always throwing new enemy types at you and new variations of enemies and different types of scenarios and stuff. So the game's constantly challenging you, which I do enjoy. You know, I like variety. Where do I go from here, I wonder? Oh, over here. Oh, crap. There we go, yeah, those counterattacks feel so satisfying to use. Oh, crap. And then you die. Yeah, this game actually, I think this game's pixel art looks pretty good. I think the visuals in this game definitely get the job done. It's got a very like gothic heavy metal aesthetic, and the music too I think is really fantastic. I think the graphics and the music is really where this game shines, and the gameplay is enjoyable as well. Yeah, so you do have levels do have all kinds of different platforming challenges and stuff for you to complete. So the game definitely has a lot of things for you. To get killed by. Lots of instant death pits as well, like little traps just to kill you. Crap. Let's do that. There we go. Yeah, I hate that. I hate the enemies that shoot projectiles. I'm not really good at countering projectiles, so they really tend to annoy me. There we go. Okay, this way he doesn't go anywhere, so here, oh crap, he's right there. Oh, it's a perfect dodge. So, oh crap, yeah, I'm trying to do it the quick way, I need to play patiently. Yeah, see, like right there, for instance, is actually a death trap. If you walk over it, it kills you. Wouldn't know it at first until you die by it. That's very reminiscent of Castlevania, where you have all these like spikes and stuff that'll just murder you if you give them a chance. Very enjoyable game. I can definitely see this game being very fun to speedrun. Sort of reminds me. It also kind of reminds me of Volgar the Viking. Ooh, got aerial enemies now. Checkpoint! Yeah, checkpoints restore your health and your mana, so that's really useful. Or mana, depending on how you want to say it. Oh crap, mom, you got ripped in the corner there. Yeah, lots of gratuitous blood. Where? Try this. I think that was... maybe I was supposed to go over here? Hmm. I think I'm supposed to kill that raven. Where'd he go? Or maybe I'm supposed to go back down. Oh, there it is, yeah. Platform right there. Okay. Yeah, there's the death spikes I was talking about. Yeah, I always love to find those in Castlevania. I think that's what killed me the most in Castlevania, was the like death spikes and then putting enemies right on the edge so that you can get hit and then fall into the spikes. Yeah, that was a really nice thing for Castlevania to do to you all the time. Oh crap, why'd I do that? Yeah. So anyway, yeah, that is actually, I'm gonna see if I got a boss battle here. Yeah, you have very interesting dialogue. I think this is where, yeah, this is a boss battle here. Or at least, whoa. Oh, wow. This is tough. Okay. Oh, wow. This area looks pretty tough. I think I'm gonna give this one more shot before ending the video. I think I can get this. Crap. Damn, wolves make it really hard to get them. There we go. Okay, whoa. Yes, this game definitely gets pretty intense. Fairly quickly the game gets difficult. Oh wow, what is this? Now here's the boss. Okay. Whoa, what the hell? Okay, let's try to get him. Oh crap. There we go. That wasn't too bad. Oh, it keeps going. Uh-oh. I got right in the middle of him. So yeah, the game is just very intense and gets very challenging fairly quickly. So you really got to get used to the parrying and the dodging and stuff. It's such an essential skill. And also timing, of course, so you can hit these projectiles back properly. There we go. Ooh, yeah, the stunts feel so good to land. Oh crap, thought I had mana. I do not. Alright. Anyway, yeah, so that's Slain, Back from Hell. Let's have a little combat tutorial here, which just gives you a, it's kind of like a refresher on the combat. I also forgot to mention that if you kill an enemy with a parry attack, you actually get more mana, so that's an interesting thing to, I should have mentioned. Anyway, yeah, that is Slain, Back from Hell. I'm actually going to show you guys the Steam store for this page, so I give you guys a bit more information on the game. We go into the Steam store page for the game here. You'll see that it's only about $13, and it's on Windows, Mac, and Linux. It's also on PS4. You can also get the game through GOG.com if you would prefer a DR-free copy. I think $13 is fair if this seems like a game you would enjoy. Like, if you're a fan of Castlevania or old-school platforming games, you know, platform action games like... well, Castlevania's the only game I can think of right now at the top of my head. But if you're a fan of games like that, and you get a lot of replay values from games that are similar to that, I think that you'll definitely enjoy this game. It's pretty short, but there are secrets and stuff and achievements, so, you know, there is some replayability there. You can also get the Deluxe Edition DLC, which comes with, which is just a bunch of, like, extras. Like, you know, you get a postcard, a wallpaper, surprise art, and the soundtrack. So that's some nice little bit of extras there. Overall, I think this game's definitely recommended if you're a fan of this genre. And another cool thing is the developer on his website, because this was a kickstarted game, the developer, Wolfbrew Games, has a page on their website where they actually thank all the Kickstarter backers, even the dollar backers. I think over 1,000 people kickstarted this game. So yeah, that's very cool of the developer to do that. Very cool of him to also update his game and improve a lot of the complaints. Anyway, yeah, guys, this has been Keith, GhostWatch57, signing out.